weren't into that. But, yeah.
I suppose what I might do is give you a little bit of a spiel on the kind of direct work we do with young people at Jigsaw, and then move it over to Lauren and Ella and Ricky for expertise in their life. I suppose the heavy lifting in terms of the work between sessions and
typical day, yeah. No pressure.
He's do you all work here? Are you all part?
So we're having a very in-depth conversation. once you get into the details, it's kind of very hard to leave a conversation. Everybody else will be very well about how to get back from the mental struggles and things that kind of very clearly.
Desire to have more confidence and competence in being able to talk about mental health, in particularly in the classroom. We are very excited by the numbers. The schools have a huge desire, I suppose, to engage with us. So it's really a shift in culture and how they're thinking about mental health and well-being for their students and for their teachers in particular.
What toolkits and what things are you introducing into the school setup in order to support teachers' well-being and children's mental health?
One of the areas they feel themselves that they are much more comfortable in talking about mental health. So we spent a lot of feedback for us is that teachers had a huge willingness to engage in the conversation, but often didn't really have the tools or the language or particular find that they can feel overwhelmed with all of the, I suppose, the expectations placed upon them.